Good morning students, I am Supnam Kaur. I am going to explain the class 10th chapter GST. Now student, in GST, what is the meaning of GST? That is goods and service tax. That means tax. First we pay the income tax and other taxes are there. But in this year, the government needs some money for their expenses. And for that, they apply the GST from the last year. That is the new concept. And in this GST, goods and service tax. Now there are two types of taxes are there. One is direct and other one is the indirect tax. Direct tax on your income. Just I have some pay and I have to pay some income tax. That is the direct tax. But one is the indirect tax. Indirect tax means when we buy, purchase something from the market, then we have to pay some tax to the government. That is also the indirect tax. That means there are two types of direct tax. One is direct and other one is indirect. Now see students, in their GST, there are two types of GSTs. One is the center government and other one is for the state government. Now what is the meaning of center and state? We know that we all belongs to one state, that is Punjab. And which tax we pay to the government of Punjab? That is the state tax. But when we pay some tax to the government of India, that is central government, that is called the central CGST, and state tax is called SGST. Now two types of there, one is inter GST and the other one is intra GST. Now see students, one we take the flight, simple to remind it, we call international. International means one nation to other. Same way, when there is inter word is there, inter word means one state to other state, and in the intra, that means inside the state. Now see students, we can say when we buy something or we purchase something from Punjab, and that going on that product produced in Punjab and we use it also in Punjab, that means that is a intra transaction. From Amritsar to Jalandhar, from Amritsar to Ludhiana, or Ludhiana to any other state or city of the Punjab, that is called intra. And in intra there is two types of GSTs are there. One is CGST and other one is SGST. Now already explained, C means central and S means state. Now GST, some percentage we have taken. Suppose there is in intra 18% is given, this percentage belongs to GST. Now what is CGST, what is SGST? Now 18%, half will go to center and half will go to this state government. Now center government will take 9% of this payment and SGST also will be 9%. That means SGST and CGST will be half half. In intra there are half for SGST and half for CGST. Now see students, first I all explain all the terms. First is cost price. What is the cost price? Cost price means when we take something from other person, we buy it, that we pay the money, that is the cost price. Next one is list price. Now you see every product, you can see at home your product, there is given MRP. MRP, that is the list price. That means that price that product producer applied on that product, that is the maximum price for that one. But after, so you see there is discount of 10%, discount of 20% on anything. After taking the discount on MRP, that list price, that price become the selling price. Suppose I take, there is a 100 rupees thing, that is the MRP. Then there is discount of 10%, that is just 10%. That means I will pay the money 10% discount on 100, that means I have to pay 90 rupees, that is the selling price. Now there are the terms cost price, then market price, then there will be discount, and after there will be selling price. Now in this one, inter and intra, I take two terms there. Inter, that that means outside the state, from Punjab to MP, from UP to MP, or MP to other any other state, or you can take a union territory also, that will be also interstate. Now in inter there is no CGST, there is no SGST. Now what is there? There is IGST. That means if the percentage is given 18%, no take 9% there, don't take 9% there, we take directly 18% on the cost price or on the selling price. If I take that one, I am just taking that, that means I have paying the cost price, I will take the GST 18% directly on that cost price. If I selling that product, that means that selling product of me become the cost price for the other one, that means 18% on the selling price. And we don't take the half, because there is no SGST, no CGST, there is directly IGST. But in intra we will take half, there will be and half there will be. It means in the condition of intrastate, the state government and that central government take the half percentage of the GST. But in the case of interstate, that means one state to other one, the whole GST will go to IGST, it means central government. There is not the part of, they will pay to the state government, but according to the norms. Then GST is applied to make all the country same tax. For that one we use this GST. Now see students, I will solve some two sums, for one for inter and other one for intra. Now there is a given sum, and one thing more, if there is not given to one state to other one, that means that is intra. One person buy something, that will he will buy from own state, but if the states are given, that means that is the interstate. Now see this, there is a given example, because there is calculation, I will do the calculation. Given second, given below the cost some financial articles. And one thing more, if one quantity price is given and the number of articles is given, then we find the first full cost there. See, there is a given cost of service on the page number 6, statement is given, find the amount of the bill. We have to find full bill, what we have to pay for that one. For following interstate, word is given interstate. Now what is the meaning of inter? That means one state to other, and one state to other, what we have to do? We have to take a full GST, don't take the half there. Now the statement, cost price of the services are given to for 2400, cost is given 2400, other one cost is given 1820. I am taking just two calculations. Then there is the GST percentage is 12% is there, and 12% is there. Now the cost is given 2400 and 1820, and the GST percentage is given 12% and 12%, and I have to just find the inter. It means I have taken the full GST. Now 2400 add the percentage of 12%, then I will do the calculation, 24 multiplied by 12, that become 288. This is the GST for this one. Now there is again 12%. Suppose there is not 12%, because if there is same, I take the 10%. Now GST rate is changed. That means this GST will be applied on this amount 1820, and 10% is there, and it become 182. Now this GST is 288, and this GST is 182. And what amount I have to pay? This is, don't take this only GST, I have to take the amount also, because cost is 2400, this cost plus its GST is 288, then next cost is 1820 and its GST is 182. This full, if I add these numbers, this become the full bill with what I have to pay. Clear student, please see it once again. We have to just see the statement, if there is a interstate, it means I have to take the full GST on once, don't take it half, and we have to do the calculation. And this is a just procedure, cost plus GST, then again cost plus GST. It becomes total bill of mine. We can do it. Please try to do it. Thank you.